Planning the design and layout of your railing is crucial for any deck project. That includes knowing how many balusters you'll need per railing section and how to space them for a symmetrical look. Here's a useful guide to determine what your project needs for each segment. As always, remember to check your local building codes before starting any installations. What you need: calculator, tape measure, paper, pencil. Use your tape measure to find the total length of your rail from post to post. In our example, we'll be working with 5 feet of railing, which equals 60 inches. From the total rail length, subtract the width of one baluster. We take off this space because there will always be one more baluster than there are spaces in the section. In our model, we're installing a standard 3/4-inch baluster. This gives us an actual rail length of 59 1/4 inches. If you're installing a unique size baluster, like a 4-inch glass or a 2-inch wooden one, this is where you would put that baluster dimension. Find your unit width, which is the width of one baluster plus the space between two balusters. In our example, our baluster width is 3/4 inch, and our space between balusters is 3.5 inches. Together, our unit width is 4 1/4 inches. The maximum open space allowed by building code is less than 4 inches. We chose 3.5 inches for the spacing in our example because it maximizes the open space in the section and minimizes the number of balusters we'll have to install. A spacing of 3.5 inches also gives us an acceptable remaining space, which we'll explain later. Use these ideas as guidelines when choosing your baluster spacing. Now, divide your actual rail length by your unit width. For us, we have an actual rail length of 59 1/4 inches. We'll divide that by our unit width of 4 1/4 inches to give us 13.9. Take the whole number from your result and multiply it by your unit width to determine the distance between the first and last baluster in the section. We'll refer to that distance as used space. In our example, our used space is 55 1/4 inches. Subtract your used space from the total rail length to find your remaining space. The remaining space is going to be the distance between your two posts and the closest baluster to them. Our actual rail length is 59 1/4 inches minus the used space of 55 1/4 inches. This brings our remaining space to 4 inches. You'll divide the remaining space amount by 2 to find that distance. In our example, we have a remaining space of 4 inches, which divided by 2 equals 2 inches between our posts and their nearest baluster. If the first and last balusters in your section look like they're too close to the posts, go back and change the original baluster spacing to find one that works for your setup. Once you've found a combination that fits, you now know 3 important items about your railing section. If the whole number from your amount of units is odd, then you will have a space at the center of your rails. If your whole number from your amount of units is even, then you will install a baluster on the center mark. Round your amount of units up to the next whole number, and that will be the total number of balusters used for that section. Now that you've found your baluster spacing and count, you can check that this spacing works for the rest of your railing. Or you can give us a call and we'll run the math for you. And if you're ready to install, go ahead and check out our playlist of baluster install videos for a look at the steps you'll be taking.
I'm Andy, part of the team here at DecksDirect. Hope you enjoyed the video. Give us a like, send us a comment. You can subscribe to get more. If you've got any questions, please give us a call at 888-824-5316. We look forward to helping you. Thanks.